Hi. So summer has started and many are worried, would our succulents thrive this hot weather? So here we are with some tips that might help you. Generally, succulents can withstand a temperature of about 45 degrees. Surprising, right? So when you're around about 45 degrees also, your succulents can thrive easily. But see that when it crosses 38 degrees, try avoiding to place in direct sunlight, because some of your succulents, the leaves may burn in this sunlight. So try to keep them in indirect sun. So let's see how we can save our succulents in this hot summer. So succulents generally need around 4 to 6 hours of sunlight. But when summer is on, you can reduce the time. You can give around 2 to 3 hours of direct sunlight and see that you are giving the morning sun, or you can give your succulents evening sunlight. And if you cannot give them direct sunlight, see that they are placed in a very warm place where they get indirect sunlight. And another important thing is it should get enough air. Insufficient air can cause suffocation to the roots, which may cause the roots to rot. So when placed in direct sunlight, see that your plant don't sit in one position. So what you have to do is, you have to just rotate the plants so that the sun falls in all sides of the plant. Why it should be rotated is that the plant leans to the sun. So to maintain the shape, you have to rotate the plant. So see that you rotate your plants at least once in a week. In summer, like humans, plants also require more water, because due to hot sun, the soil dries up quickly. So based on the temperature, you can even water your succulents daily. So you can use your fingers to check whether the soil is wet inside, around 1 to 1.5 inches. So here, what I'm going to do is, I'm just going to use in here bud to check whether the water, the soil is moist. So what I'm going to do is, I'm just going to take a here bud and I'm just going to put it inside the pot. So when I do so, what happens is that you just check. I'm just going to leave it inside and I'm just going to check whether the soil is moist or it is dry. So when I take the here bud back, if the soil sticks up to the bud, then it means that there is moisture in the soil. So here you can see that it has come out dry. So it is the right time to water. So I'll just show you another pot where I'm going to insert this bud and show you whether the soil is moist or not. So this was watered 3 days earlier. So now I've just take the bud and you can see that there is some soil stuck to the here bud. So I'll just water it the next day. Okay, so when you do like this 1 or 2 days, then you will get used to when to water your succulents. So water your succulents early in the morning, and during the summer you can even water them in the evening. But don't water them in the evening during your winter, because there is a chance for your plants to get infected by fungus. So water you can directly pour on the top soil, or you can keep small plates, water the pot plates and wait until the top soil becomes moist. See that the water flows out easily, because succulents generally don't like waterlogged soil. So that, see that your soil is good enough. So you can go for succulent soil mix, or you can prepare your own. So how to prepare your soil, a detailed description is given in the description box. Water your succulents in such a way that they flow out easily through the drainage hole. So next water, when the soil is dry, you can water it in the same way. Special care in this extreme heat is a must. So the best option is using your shade nets. Shade nets comes in 3 different shades: 50%, 75% and 90%. So it filters the direct sunlight and it allows only 50% or 25% or 10% sun to enter on your plants. So you can use shade nets in order to save your succulents and also all your plants. Humidity plays an important role in summer. Water evaporates quickly and leaves the soil dry frequently. So in order to this humidity not to affect your plants, you can go with mulching. So mulching can be done with biodegradable products. So you can use sphagnum moss or normal moss. You can use dry grass straws, tree barks, and also you can use newspapers to cover your pots. So here I'll show you how to cover your pots with coco feet. So here I've just used some soaked coco feet on top of the plants. I've also used some leaf mold. I just cover the leaf mold with the pots. The dry soil, I'm just covering it with leaf mold. So what happens is that by covering so, the sun doesn't evaporate all the water which is in the soil. So the plant will get enough water. It doesn't dehydrate easily. So another option is that you can also apply pebbles to the topsoil. So when you apply pebbles also, the evaporation of your water due to sun will be less. You can also use normal stones to cover your topsoil. So all these will help you to save from humidity. So another process is that you can use pebbles and you can water that, you can pour water on the pebbles, and again you can place a pot on that and keep your succulents over that. So what happens is that this will lessen the humidity around, and it will be sufficient, the humidity will be sufficient for your plant to grow. So if you have large number of plants, what you can do is you can use a big bowl of water, a tub of water, you can take it and keep it near your plants so that the humidity would be reduced and it will be good not only for your succulents but all the plants. So succulents, talking about summer, summer is also the growth period for most of the plants. Usually, you see, succulents need not be fertilized. And if you think that you want to fertilize your plants, then the summer is the right time for you to fertilize your plants. So to sustain the plant growth, you can use manures. Manures like dried cow dung, vermicompost, bone meal. You can also use oil cakes like neem cake. You can apply all these once in a month or 3 weeks so that your plant grows quickly. Also, repot your succulents in regular intervals. Like succulents, cactus don't need so much of care. They can easily withstand this hot summer. As they are desert plants, no much protection is required. So they can easily cope up with this summer. Hope you like this video. So grow more plants to get more oxygen during this pandemic period. Hope you like our video. A special thanks to Pharos ma'am and Ilaverasi ma'am for helping us to do this video. Thank you everyone. Happy gardening. Please do subscribe our channel. Thank you so much.